Carol at Lincoln Center. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Julie Andrews and Miss Carol Burnett.
Here we are.
Yeah, I can't believe it. Back together again in a Philharmonic Hall. Wow.
Listen, do you remember the last time we did a show like this together?
Oh, I certainly do. It was at Carnegie Hall, and we had so much fun we couldn't wait to do it again.
Mm-hmm. And we vowed we wouldn't let another birthday go by before we did another show together.
Yeah, just think, that was 10 years ago.
Mm-hmm. And here we are today, both 1 year older. Tell me, dear, what have you been doing with yourself all these years? You'll have to excuse me, but we've been so out of touch, you know. What I really want to know is, are you still in the entertainment field?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I am. I'm on television a lot.
Oh, what a shame.
Tell me, what have you been doing with yourself all these years? You'll have to forgive me, we've been so out of touch.
Well, actually, I've been working in motion pictures.
Oh, how nice!
Talkies?
You must remember, while we were doing that show at Carnegie Hall, there was talk about my going out to Hollywood to do The Sound of Music.
Oh, yes, I remember. Oh, yeah, say, did that thing ever come off?
You know I'm putting you on.
Yes, so am I. I want you to know I've been looking forward to working with you after all these years.
That's exactly the way I feel, but I want you to promise me one thing.
What?
That you're not going to cut up tonight like you did at Carnegie Hall.
Me?
No, really, I want to make it clear that here, tonight, yes, at Lincoln Center, Julie, we couldn't, we mustn't, we can't. Misbehave tonight.
Yes, but dear.
Very grand, very grave tonight. And I hope you agree.
Listen, you're the one I'm worried about. We ought to, we've got to, we have to, we must be legit tonight. I'll play the ladylike bit tonight. Sing appropriately.
Appropriately.
Some Verdi.
Concerti.
And a very proper operatic aria.
How do you do that?
Practice.
Minotti.
Scarlatti.
Or an oratorio.
To be hand in hand, it's so grand. In this grandiose house tonight.
Nothing cheaper than Strauss tonight.
Tonight.
Please, God, don't let her goof tonight.
Are you speaking of me?
I don't see anybody else up
Well,
there.
Watch it. No mugging, no slugging.
No vamping, no camping around tonight.
Dear, try to keep your gown down tonight.
Me? I'm the mother of three.
Julie, how would your children feel if they saw you acting silly?
Well, they'd probably cry a lot. But listen, how do your kids feel when they see you on television every week,
well,
making a fool of yourself?
They break out in hives.
So we're ladies, we're moms, we're dolls to the tips of our toes tonight.
And nothing knockabout goes tonight.
Don't rain me fast.
Time. Rah-dee-ah-dah. Charleston.
The pony odor.
We will not muck about.
Right.
No breaking it up.
No cutting a rug.
No busting a gut.
No jitterbug.
No going to town.
No coming undone.
No horsing around.
No, no fun.
And no.
Let it go.
Oh, heck. Hey, couldn't we do just one chorus of Wait Till the Sun Shines, Nelly?
Oh, Julie.
Oh.
It's our classy.
Glossy.
Gossy.
Gassy. Classical
Excuse me.
Ugh. Oh, hello, Florence.
Oh, hi, Lillian.
Well, how are you?
Oh, don't ask. I hate this instrument.
You know you don't mean that. It's a marvelous instrument. You play it beautifully.
Big deal. 23 years I've been playing this thing, and all I got to show for it is splinters in my body stocking. What a time I had getting here. I couldn't get a taxi. I couldn't get on the bus with this thing, and they won't let me on the subway.
Well, how come your husband Harry didn't help you with it?
Who, him? It's too much trouble for him just to carry his drumsticks. Besides, I wouldn't ask him.
Uh-oh, don't tell me you two had another fight.
Uh-huh.
What was it about this time?
Something terrible. I think he's seeing another woman.
Oh, I can't believe that.
Well, I find it hard to believe, too. After all, why should he want another woman when he can have me? What's wrong with me?
You're flat. Your A's a little under.
Oh.
Uh-oh, we're about to start. Here comes Lenny. Tell me, who do you think it is your husband is seeing?
Who else? Mona, the harpist.
What makes you think it's Mona?
Because she's got a thing about symphony musicians. Oh, look at her over there, so smug and confident. I hope you break every fingernail in your body.
Well, what makes you so sure he's carrying on with Mona?
Knowing Harry, it's got to be somebody in the orchestra, and she's the only other girl here besides you and me.
Well, I still think you're jumping to conclusions. Harry's just not that kind of a person. I mean, he's warm, he's good, he's kind, he's gentle, he's generous, he's thoughtful, he's strong, he's manly, he's virile, he's understanding.
So it's you!
Don't be silly.
Don't tell me I'm silly.
You are being silly.
You're lying. I should have known it was you playing around behind my back. Look at him. So innocent, Mr. Drummer Man. He thinks I don't know what's going on between you two.
Believe me, there's nothing going on.
Oh, no. Then what was that?
What was what?
What Harry just played on the timpani. Boom, diddy, boom, diddy, boom, boom. Don't think I don't know what those two extra boom booms mean.
Oh. Honestly.
You're not fooling me. It's a code. It means I'll meet you later in the boom boom room. Oh, why?
I should have known it was you, of course. Why else would he be sitting around the house all day in his bathrobe listening to those Florian Zayback records? After 17 choruses of a hot canary, I should have suspected something.
All right, I admit it. It's true. But don't blame Harry. It wasn't his fault. It was fate. It all started during a performance of Peter and the Wolf. We were playing one of those wonderful young people's concerts. We started with the Andante Cantabile. Next thing we knew, we were involved in the Molto Presto, followed by the Allegro Furioso, and we finished off the afternoon by going all the way from the Del Signo to the Finale Ultimo without stopping.
You did that in front of all those kids.
Well, that was Sunday. We couldn't help ourselves. We saw each other Monday night, Tuesday night, Wednesday night, Thursday night. Well, what else could we do?
Rest 2, 3, 4.
He lied to me. That's where he was all those nights. He told me he took a job with a dance band in Jersey so he could make enough money to put a down payment on a waterbed. Little did he realize this would leak out before the bed did.
Face it, Florence, you're a loser.
I can't believe it.
Well, you'd better believe it.
I can't.
It's true.
Wait a second. Did you hear that?
Hear what?
Harry's changed his mind. He still loves me. He just told me. He played 3 extra boom booms.
You're crazy. He loves me. Don't you, Harry?
No, he doesn't. He loves me. Don't you, Harry?
Hall has always been noted for presenting to its audiences the greatest performers from the world of dance. And one of the most famous is Madame Norma Abanel, who made her American debut in 1914 and has been thrilling crowds the world over ever since. Tonight, in another farewell performance, here is Madame Abanel with her dancers to give her interpretation of one of the classic tales of Greek mythology, Electra and the Passions of the Gods. There once existed a village known to all as the Village of the Gods. It was in this village that lived Uranus, god of the heavens, Gaia, god of the earth, Tethys, god of the ocean, Thor, god of thunder, Zeus, Hestia, Prometheus, gods of every description. In fact, it was said that in the Village of the Gods, one could look for miles around and hardly ever see a regular person. As legend has it, in the Village of the Gods there lived only one woman, the beautiful young maiden Electra, virtuous, pure, innocent, and possessed of a beauty so surpassing that every god sought to have her for his own. Here now, in another one of her farewell performances, at the age of 83, performing the role of the beautiful maiden Electra, here is Madame Norma Avenel.
Apollo, who had just returned from the wars. She found herself unable to resist his attention. Virtuous, pure, and innocent. She was also ready. She swore her love to Apollo, and as legend has it, this ticked off the gods. To create someone in her own image. She hoped this would appease the gods and hopefully get them off her back. Upon which to shower their love.
Electra were so in love with Apollo and were so taken by his strength, beauty, and physical majesty that she had failed to realize that he also liked to fool around. Realizing that she had lost the love of Apollo, Electra calls upon the great god Thor, god of thunder, to come to her aid. God of the dummies.
But he's coming back if he goes 10,000 miles. And who will tie my shoe? And who
stay.
Daddy who'll tie my shoe, and Mama who'll glove my hand. But it's you, you who'll kiss my lips when you come back. Look away.
Did our last show together, we had a chance to sing all of our favorite songs. Well, practically all, everything except Wait Till the Sun Shines, Nellie, and she wouldn't let me do it then either.
Now, I told you I would love to do that song. I really would. But remember what we promised. We said that this is supposed to be a classy show, and Nellie just isn't right for a place like this.
Well, you're right, Carol. Classy it is. Yes. So, ladies and gentlemen, ce soir, nous allons commencer où nous sommes finis. À Carnegie Hall, nous avons présenté un mélange de chansons de l'année 1900. Maintenant, nous aimerions continuer avec les 10 ans passés.
For those of you who don't understand Spanish, what she's trying to say is that when we did Carnegie Hall, we did a whole bunch of songs from the year 1900 on, and now we want to catch up on the wonderful songs that were written in the last 10 years. Right, Julie?
Oui, peut-on commencer?
Oui. Voulez-vous hit it, Pete?
We're Sergeant Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. We hope you will enjoy the show. We're Sergeant Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. Sit back and let the evening go.
What would you do if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me?
Probably. Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song, and I'll try not to sing out of key. I get
high with the little girl from my friend.
I get high with the little girl from my friend. I'm gonna try with the little girl from my friend.
Sergeant Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. Sergeant Pepper's Lonely Hearts.
And the beat goes on.
I did.
Wow, 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 wow.
a line. Wakes up in the morning with his hair down his eyes, and he says,
that keeps you in the back roads by the rivers of my memory, that keeps you ever gentle on my mind.
And if that's not loving me,
then all I've got to say, I think about your face and go to ease my mind.
And honey, I love you, and I'm being
we've looked at love from both sides now.
And I'd love to be with you
if the world would stop revolving, spinning slow.
What the world
the dawning of the age of Aquarius.
The age of Aquarius. 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 Aquarius.
The only one who could ever reach me was the son of a preacher man.
Hey, the only one who could ever reach me was the son of a preacher man.
Oh, he was?
Yes, he was.
But that rat!
Dirty, rotten.
Oh! What kind of fool am I?
Got a hot double date, rotten da da, rotten da da, icky and sticky.
We've done Carnegie Hall,
Lincoln Center. How about Julie and Carol at the Palace?
Oh, that's terrific. We could do the Dolly Sisters and Nora Bays.
No, dear. House. Not that palace.
You mean?
Why not?
Buckingham?
Buckingham.
The part of Apollo was played by Don Crichton.